Did you know that Uber has found yet another way to play takeaway with your and my revenue? Well, they have, and in this video, I'm gonna break it out. And stick around, at the end of the video, I'll share with you my solution to the situation. Hey everybody, this is Jay Crater with The Rideshare Guy. So towards the end of last year, Uber announces Uber Pro program, and it's a rewards program, has four levels. It starts out a partner, then it goes to gold, then to platinum, and then to diamond. And at the top two levels, at platinum, you got a 3% bump on your time and distance. And at diamond, you got a 6% bump in your time and distance. And I calculated that to be like $4,000 or $5,000 extra per year driving full time, like I was. And I thought, good on you, Uber. Well, let me tell you what's happened. So they rolled this thing out in some test markets, and we heard from some of our readers and people that watch our videos that said, yeah, they were getting the 3% and the 6% bump. But then on May 1st, it all stopped. Uber took it away. In San Francisco, when they announced that Uber Pro was coming and it started here, they didn't even offer the 3% or the 6%. So they gave it to us and then they took it away. And they said they would make it up with the Uber Quest bonuses. But many of our readers said, no, it didn't really make up for it. So let me explain how a magician works. A magician works with two hands. So one hand has something interesting, right? Something that's sort of, it's a rabbit, it's a tissue, it's a magic wand, right? And you're mesmerized by it. You're watching it, maybe it's some sunglasses. And while you're watching over here, this hand over here is doing the real work. And that's exactly what's happening here. Both Uber and Lyft have a habit of promising us a lot of little things. And then we're all like, that's great. But then they're taking away, they're cutting the rates, they're cutting our mileage rates. And here Uber in particular is taking away the 3% and the 6%. And hopefully you don't see it. So that's how a magician works, and that's exactly what's going on here. They offered a 3% and a 6% bump in pay, real significant amount of money, and gone. So let's take a look at the Quest bonus. So when I first started, I was able to drive 120 trips and make a $500 bonus. Now look at this here. This is absolutely appalling. What you can see here is that I am getting offered a whopping $55 for completing 70 trips. That's laughable. And that's supposed to make up for not getting a 6% bump on time and distance. The numbers obviously don't add up. Not only are they taking the 3% and a 6% away, but they're also lowering the Quest bonus at the same time. So no matter how you look at it, it's a disappointing development in the revenue stream for drivers who specifically work with Uber. Now this begs the question, why do they do it this way? I mean, do we really think that they thought it was a good idea and they launched it and then they realized it was not a good idea? Do we really think that it was that careless of a decision? No. I think what it is what's the old called bait and switch. Bait and switch. So they tempt you with something, they get you used to it. You start to think, wow, this is really good, this is really good, this is really good. And then they take it away. And they're hoping, they're counting on the fact that you've gotten into the habit of working with Uber. And even though they're slowly taking things away, you're just going to keep working with them. That's the bait and switch. You draw people in with something very interesting, right? Very attractive, very mesmerizing, something you really want. And then as you get closer to it, you got into the habit of moving in that direction. They take it away and it's gone. But you stick around, you still keep doing what you've been doing because you've gotten into that habit. So here's my key takeaway from what we've gone over so far. You can expect this kind of behavior to continue, right? We've seen it over and over and over again. Things just keep getting a little bit worse for the drivers. We're the big expense. They're gonna keep finding ways to pay us a little bit less. So what you need to do is figure out, are you happy with this and are you going to continue to do this, right? Because you know that's now going to keep happening. It's as relentless as the rain, right? These little price cuts. Or are you going to get to work on something else, right? Because at some point, it's going to be so bad that you're going to want to jump ship. And when you do, you want to have something to go to. This is what I call a plan B. And this is another example of why you want to get to work on your plan B. Start creating something new for yourself, something where you can do what you want to do and not be dependent on a company like Uber, who obviously we cannot trust, who obviously is continuing to take little bits away from us. So take it as good news, okay? We can count on Uber to keep dropping the price, keep lowering how much we get paid. That's what's going to happen. So know that. Don't hope that they're going to change, and do something about it. That's the takeaway. Take action, be proactive, go make something happen in your life so that you have a plan B and move towards that. And that can be one of the most exciting and fulfilling things that can happen out of this situation. This is Jay Crater with The Rideshare Guy. I hope you have a go out and have a great day. And if you haven't signed up yet to receive these videos, subscribe to our channel. Join our team. We'd love to have you. Stay on top of everything that's happening. We give you lots of tips and tools and ways you can make more money in less time. You'll go out and have a great day. Be safe out there. Bye for now.